Yesterday I was speaking about the crucifixion of the Lord Jesus Christ, and now I want to go on to the resurrection, the third day. This is Luke 24, and upon the first day of the week, very early in the morning, they came unto the sepulchre, bringing the spices which they had prepared, and certain others with them. And they found the stone rolled away from the sepulchre, and they entered in, and found not the body of the Lord Jesus. And it came to pass, as they were much perplexed thereabout, behold, two men stood by them in shining garments. And as they were afraid, they bowed down their faces to the earth. They said unto them, Why seek ye the living among the dead? He is not here, but is risen. Remember how he spake unto you when he was yet in Galilee, saying, The Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men, and be crucified, and the third day rise again. And they remembered his words, and returned from the sepulchre, and told all these things unto the 11 and to all the rest. It was Mary Magdalene, and Joanna, and Mary, the mother of James, and other women that were with them, which told these things unto the apostles. And their words seemed to be to them as idle tales, and they believed them not. Then arose Peter and ran unto the sepulchre, and stooping down, he beheld the linen clothes laid by themselves, and departed, wondering in himself at that which was come to pass. And behold, two of them went that same day to a village called Emmaus, which was from Jerusalem about 60 furlongs, about 60 furlongs. And they talked together of all these things which had happened. And it came to pass that while they communed together and reasoned, Jesus himself drew near and went with them. But their eyes were holden that they should not know him. And he said unto them, What manner of communications are these that ye have one to another, as ye walk and are sad? And the one of them, whose name was Cleophas, answering, said unto him, Art thou only a stranger in Jerusalem, and hast not known the things which are come to pass there in these days? And he said unto them, What things? And they said unto him, Concerning Jesus of Nazareth, which was a prophet, mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, and how the chief priests and our rulers delivered him to be condemned to death, and have crucified him. He trusted that it had been he which should have redeemed Israel. And beside all this, today is the third day since these things were done. Yea, and certain women also of our company made us astonished, which were early at the sepulchre. And when they found not his body, they came, saying that they had also seen a vision of angels, which said that he was alive. Yes, he rose again the third day according to the scriptures, exactly as he said he would, after being crucified for your sins and mine. And certain of them which were with us went to the sepulchre, and found it even so as the women had said. But him they saw not. Then he said unto them, O fools and slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken, ought not Christ to have suffered these things, and to enter into his glory? And beginning at Moses and all the prophets, he expounded unto them in all the scriptures the things concerning himself. And they drew near unto the village, where they went, and he made as though he would have gone further. But they constrained him, saying, Abide with us, for it is toward evening, and the day is far spent. And he went in to tarry with them. And it came to pass, as he sat at meat with them, as it was said, it was prophesied hundreds of years before, that he would rise the third day after his crucifixion for you and for me. You and I, because we're sinners in the sight of the Lord, we have a gap between God and ourselves. It's been caused by sin, a separation. And you and I need to come back unto God. The only way we can come back to him is through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ and his finished work upon the cross of Calvary. And they said one to another, did not our heart burn within us while he talked with us by the way, and while he opened to us the scriptures? And they rose up the same hour and returned to Jerusalem, and found the 11 gathered together, and them that were with them, saying, The Lord is risen indeed, and hath appeared to Simon. And they told what things were done in the way, and how he was known of them in breaking of bread. And as they thus spake, Jesus himself stood in the midst of them, and saith unto them, Peace be unto you. But they were terrified and affrighted, and supposed that they had seen a spirit. And he said unto them, Why are ye troubled? And why do thoughts arise in your hearts? Behold my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Handle me and see. For a spirit hath not flesh and bones, as ye see me have. So he was showing them his hands and his feet. And those scars, those nail scars, were in his hands and his feet. He was showing his disciples this proof that he is the Christ. He's risen from among the dead. This third day, the resurrection day had come. And he's risen from the dead the third day after being crucified for your sin and mine. He himself has no sin. He knew no sin, did no sin, and in him is no sin. And yet he was made sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. So if you come in repentance toward God this afternoon, in other words, change your mind, agree with God that you are a sinner, and then put your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, your soul will be saved. You'll have peace with God. You'll have an everlasting home in heaven for all eternity. In the finished work of Jesus Christ upon that cross. The one who was crucified in weakness, it seemed, but raised by the power of Almighty God. The third day, he'd risen from the dead, and this was proof. Thus said, he showed these his disciples his hands and his feet. As he said, Behold my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Handle me and see, for a spirit hath not flesh and bones, as ye see me have. Notice he said, not flesh and blood. He'd shed all of his blood on account of your sin and mine. In whom we have redemption, through his blood even, the forgiveness of sins. I wonder, is your soul saved this afternoon as you walk past? Are you at peace with God? The Bible says, therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. For a spirit hath not flesh and bones, as ye see me have. And when he had thus spoken, he showed them his hands and his feet. And while they yet believed not for joy, and wondered, he said unto them, Have ye here any meat? And they gave him a piece of broiled fish, that's a grilled fish, and of an honeycomb. And he took it, and did eat before them. And he said unto them, Take, these are the words which I spake unto you while I was yet with you, that all things must be fulfilled which were written in the law of Moses, and in the prophets, and in the Psalms concerning me. Then opened he their understanding, that they might understand the scriptures. And said unto them, Thus it is written, and thus it behove Christ to suffer, and to rise from the dead the third day, and that repentance and remission, that simply means forgiveness of sins, should be preached in his name among all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. And here we are in the land of Oz, and we're still preaching the same message unto you. Peace by Jesus Christ. The only way of peace with God is through the Lord Jesus Christ. He's made peace through the blood of his cross. If you come in repentance to what God has said, you'll admit the fact that you're a sinner before the God of heaven, and then place your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, your soul will be saved. He went on to say, and ye are witnesses of these things. And behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you, that tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until ye be endued with power from on high. And he led them out as far as to Bethany, and he lifted up his hands and blessed them. And it came to pass, while he blessed them, he was parted from them and carried up into heaven. And they worshipped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy, and were continually in the temple, praising and blessing God. Amen. Now, the Gospel of John, chapter 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. This is speaking of none other than our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ himself. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. Another scripture says that God created all things by Jesus Christ. And so we need to understand that the Lord Jesus Christ is the creator of this whole universe. And you and I are personally accountable to that God. Every one of us shall give account of himself to God. I wonder, how is it with you? If you were to die right now, where would you be? Would you be in heaven through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ? Or would you be down in hell because you've rejected or neglected the Lord Jesus Christ, who this afternoon desires to be your Saviour? Yes, he's a Saviour available for the whole world, but not all people are saved. We've got to believe in him. We've got to receive him. You see, he came under his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, that's Jesus Christ, of them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. We'll see that later on in the reading. It says here, in him was life, that is, in the Lord Jesus Christ was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him. This is Jesus Christ. And the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, that's Jesus Christ, then gave him power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. John bare witness of him, and cried, saying, this was he of whom I spake. He that cometh after me is preferred before me, for he was before me. And of his fullness have all we received grace for grace. For the law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. You see, the law was our schoolmaster to bring us unto Christ, that we might understand where we'd go wrong, where we'd fail, where we'd sin. The law is a set of commandments to bring us into condemnation, and to point us to the person of Jesus Christ. That is the purpose of the law, that we might understand that we are guilty, hell-deserving sinners on our way down the hill. But God does not want that. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. What do you have? That everlasting life that can only come through faith in our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. Grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. No man has seen God at any time, the only begotten Son, which is in the bosom of the Father, he hath declared him, and he hath found him out. And this is the record of John, when the Jews sent priests and Levites from Jerusalem to ask him, Who art thou? And he confessed and denied not, but confessed, I am not the Christ. In other words, he's not God's anointed. He's not the chosen one of God. He's not the Lord Jesus Christ. He is the voice of one crying in the wilderness. The same as I'm here. Crying in the wilderness of this world for you to seek the Lord's salvation. Salvation that is only possible through the name of the Lord Jesus Christ that is once for all sacrificed upon the cross. And they asked him, they asked John, What then, art thou Elias? And he said, I am not. Art thou that prophet? And he answered, No. Then said they unto him, Who art thou, that we may give an answer to them that sent us? What sayest thou of thyself? He said, I am the voice of one crying in the wilderness, Make straight the way of the Lord, as said the prophet Isaiah. And they which were sent were of the Pharisees. And they asked him, and said unto him, Why baptizest thou then, if thou be not that Christ, nor Elias, neither that prophet? John answered them, saying, I baptize with water, but there standeth one among you, whom ye know not. He it is, who coming after me is preferred before me, whose shoes latcheth I am not worthy to unloose. These things were done in Bethabara, beyond Jordan, where John was baptizing. The next day John seeth Jesus coming unto him, and saith, Behold, the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world. This would be my cry too. Behold the Lamb of God, the Lord Jesus Christ. Look steadfastly upon him. Realize that he's the only one, the only way back to God from the dark paths of sin is our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who was crucified that day upon the cross. Yes, behold, the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world. Have your sins been washed away in the precious blood of the Lord Jesus Christ as a lamb without blemish and without spot? The only perfect man died upon a cross and was crucified that day for you and for me, out of love for you and for me. But God commendeth, that means he exhibited, his love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. This is he of whom I said, After me cometh a man which is preferred before me, for he was before me. And I knew him not, but that he should be manifest, or made manifest to Israel. Therefore am I come baptizing with water. And John bare record, saying, I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove, and it abode upon him. And I knew him not. And he that sent me to baptize with water, the same said unto me, Upon whom thou shalt see the Spirit descending and remaining on him, the same is he which baptizeth with the Holy Spirit. And I saw, and bear record, that this is the Son of God. Again the next day, after John stood at two of his disciples, and looking upon Jesus as he walked, he said, Behold, the Lamb of God. And the two disciples heard him speak, and they followed Jesus. Then Jesus turned and saw them following, and said unto them, What seek ye? They said unto him, Rabbi, which is to say, being interpreted, Master, where dwellest thou? In other words, where dost thou live? He saith unto them, Come and see. They came and saw where he dwelt, and abode with him that day, for it was about the tenth hour. One of the two which heard John speak and followed him was Andrew, Simon Peter's brother. He first findeth his own brother Simon, and saith unto him, We have found the Messiah, which is being interpreted the Christ. And he brought him to Jesus, and when Jesus beheld him, he said, Thou art Simon, the son of Jonah. Thou shalt be called Cephas, which is by interpretation a stone. The day following, Jesus would go forth into Galilee, and findeth Philip, and saith unto him, Follow me. Now Philip was of Bethsaida, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip findeth Nathanael, and saith unto him, We have found him of whom Moses in the law and the prophets did write, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph. And Nathanael said unto him, Can there any good thing come out of Nazareth? Philip saith unto him, Come and see. Jesus saw Nathanael coming to him, and saith of him, Behold, an Israelite indeed, in whom is no guile, or no craftiness, or sneakiness. Nathanael saith unto him, Whence knowest thou me? In other words, where dost thou know me from? Jesus answered and said unto him, Before that Philip called thee, when thou wast under the fig tree, I saw thee. Nathanael answered and said unto him, Rabbi, thou art the Son of God, thou art the King of Israel. Jesus answered and said unto him, Because I said unto thee, I saw thee under the fig tree, believest thou? Thou shalt see greater things than these. And he saith unto him, Verily, verily, or truly, truly, I say unto you, Hereafter ye shall see heaven open, and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man, meaning himself. John chapter 2. And the third day there was a marriage in Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. And both Jesus was called and his disciples to the marriage. And when they wanted wine, the mother of Jesus saith unto him, They have no wine. Jesus saith unto her, Woman, what have I to do with thee? Mine hour is not yet come. His mother saith unto the servants, Whatsoever he saith unto you, do it. And there were set there six water pots of stone, after the manner of the purifying of the Jews, containing two or three firkins apiece. Jesus saith unto them, Fill the water pots with water. And they filled them up to the brim. And he saith unto them, Draw out now, and bear unto the governor of the feast. And they bear it. When the ruler of the feast had tasted the water that was made wine, and knew not whence it was, or where it was, but the servants which drew the water knew, the governor of the feast called the bridegroom, saith unto him, Every man at the beginning doth set forth good wine. When men have well drunk, then that which is worse. But thou hast kept the good wine until now. This beginning of miracles did Jesus in Cana of Galilee, and manifested forth his glory. And his disciples believed on him. After this he went down to Capernaum, he and his mother and his brethren and his disciples, and they continued there not many days. And the Jews' Passover was at hand, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem, and found in the temple those that sold oxen and sheep and doves, and the changers of money sitting. And when he had made a scourge or a whip of small cords, he drove them all out of the temple, and the sheep, and the oxen, and poured out the changers' money, and overthrew the tables. Said unto them that sold doves, Take these things hence. Make not my Father's house a house of merchandise. And his disciples remembered that it was written, The zeal of thine house hath eaten me up. Then answered the Jews and said unto him, What sign showest thou unto us, seeing that thou doest these things? Jesus answered and said unto them, Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up. Then said the Jews, 46 years was this temple in building, and wilt thou rear it up in 3 days? But he spake of the temple of his body. When therefore he was risen from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this unto them. And they believed the scripture and the word which Jesus had said. Destroy this temple, meaning his body. Yes, he was going to be crucified. Eventually he was going to be taken by wicked hands, sinful men, taken and slain and crucified. Crucified and slain on the cross. Because of your sins and my sins. He is the one that has paid the ultimate price for our sins in his own precious blood being shed upon the cross of Calvary. He said, Destroy this temple, meaning his body, and in 3 days I'll raise it up. The third day he rose again according to the scriptures. As we saw in Luke chapter 24, they came to the sepulchre and the stone was rolled away. He wasn't there. He didn't need anyone to roll the stone away. He just went straight through that stone. He rose again the third day according to the scriptures. He's a living, loving Saviour. He desires to save your soul this afternoon. The question is, what will you do then with Jesus, which is called the Christ? Will he be your Saviour? He's longing that you might reach out the hand of faith unto him and believe on him and receive him as your Saviour. Without that, we're dead in our trespasses and in our sins, going down to hell. If I didn't tell you that to warn you, I wouldn't be a faithful servant of Jesus Christ. I'm here to warn you to flee from the wrath which is to come. God is angry with the wicked every day. That is those who are not saved, those who are not his children. It's because of our wicked works in our minds that he's angry with us. But he wants to be our friends. The only way we can be the friend of God is by believing on his Son, by receiving his Son as our Saviour. He will either be your Saviour or he'll have to be your judge. I wonder what will it be for you. It's up to you. Your eternal destiny depends on what you do with our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. When therefore he was risen from the dead, as I said, his disciples remembered that he had said this unto them, destroy this temple and in 3 days I'll raise it up. And they believed the scripture and the word which Jesus had said. Now when he was in Jerusalem at the Passover, in the feast day, many believed in his name when they saw the miracles which he did. But Jesus did not commit himself unto them, because he knew all men, and needed not that any should testify of man, for he knew what was in man. They might say, well, what is in man? Well, we have a sinful nature that causes us to want to sin and do our own thing and rebel against the God of heaven. And we need to understand that we can't save ourselves by any way, shape or form. Any amount of good works could never earn the favour of God on our behalf. It can never make us enter into heaven by doing good works which will outweigh our bad works. We need to understand that. But without faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, as I said before, we are dead in our trespasses and in our sins, heading down to hell. And God does not want us to end up in hell. He wants to be your Saviour this afternoon. And your salvation rises and falls on what you do with the Lord Jesus Christ. He'll either be your Saviour, as I keep on saying, or he'll have to be your judge. I wonder what will it be for you, Saviour or judge, salvation or damnation. Make a wise choice this afternoon. Get right with God while there's still time and opportunity. Time is running out. We need to understand that the time is short. The time is running out. The Lord Jesus Christ will return. He's going to return into the air to take the Christians to be forever with himself. I wonder, will you be left behind to go through the 7-year tribulation period upon this earth? Terrible time, especially the last 3.5 years. The world's never known anything like it. You might think Corona's bad. You haven't seen anything yet. There's going to be wars and rumors of wars. These things will take place in the tribulation, the time that we call the tribulation. Last 3.5 years of the 7 is called the Great Tribulation. No, you can be left behind in those days. You can be caught up to meet the Lord in the air through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ alone. Neither is there salvation in any other. There is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. The Lord Jesus Christ will be your Saviour, or he'll have to be your judge. Come to the one who said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. What will you do then with Jesus, which is called the Christ? Remember, in whom we have redemption, through his blood even, the forgiveness of sins. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. If you're interested in this, look me up, youtube.com/peace by Jesus Christ. God bless you, and thanks for listening.